A very happy morning to you, my dear students. You all know that very recently in the month of August, which national festival we all celebrated? Our Independence Day. 15th August was celebrated as our Independence Day. How did we get this Independence Day, the day India achieved freedom from the British rule? And how did we achieve it? It was the struggle of our great leaders who fought, who struggled to achieve this freedom, to free our nation from the British rule. And so, we all are now enjoying freedom. Do you all value this freedom that our freedom strugglers have achieved for our nation? Do you? Have you ever realized the importance of this freedom? Yes, students. Because we are free to move to different places, different states, free to speak our mind, follow the religion of our choice. Yes, and so we should feel blessed that we are born in this free country. Okay, and today we are going to learn about this freedom struggle. So, in general knowledge, our lesson number 8, our freedom struggle. We are going to learn about our freedom strugglers. The leaders who worked, who struggled to bring freedom to our nation. So, here, as you all know, who is he? The father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhiji. What was his role? He had the vital role in the freedom struggle of India. The most important role was of our father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhiji. And it is through his non-cooperation movement. You can see in this picture, first picture, non-cooperation movement. The very word means we are not going to cooperate. And how did they not cooperate? They did not cooperate to buy the Britishers' foreign goods. Because the Britishers have come to do trade in India. And they were forcing the people in India, and Indians also love to buy British goods. Yes? So through non-cooperation they decided to boycott, not to buy the foreign goods. So it is through this little non-cooperation movement, then the civil disobedience movement, that is, not to obey, they refuse to obey the laws which the British has framed for the Indians to follow. And last but not the least, the Quit India movement, where they wanted the British to leave India. Quit, quit means leave. So slogans were in Simon, go back, quit India, leave India. Why? Because they wanted the British to go. And Mahatma Gandhiji, through these non-cooperation movement, civil disobedience, Quit India movement, all these movements, children, it was non-violent movement. No violence, no fighting, no killing, no shedding blood. He believed in non-violent method. And that is what is appreciated worldwide. A man who, without fighting, without shedding blood, without violence, it is through his non-violent and a very peaceful method, he achieved freedom for our nation. And it is appreciated all over the world. So this was Mahatma Gandhi's way of achieving, struggling to achieve freedom for our nation. Who next? Sardar Vallabhai Patel. Yes, Sardar Vallabhai Patel, he is popularly called by everyone as the Iron Man of India. Iron, you all know how tough it is. And this man is believed to be the Iron Man of India. And what are his contributions for our freedom struggle? He also actively participated with Mahatma Gandhi. You can see him sitting next to Mahatma Gandhi. And he participated in whatever iron man Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel cooperated with him and actively participated in it and helped to fight against the British policy. Besides that, he was a very knowledgeable man, so he worked against social evils. Our country was not just facing the problem from the British rule, our country was facing problem within also. Our people, they're following certain social norms, like social evil practice, like untouchability. Isko chuna nahi hai, ye high caste, low caste. So untouchability, caste discrimination. Main Brahmin hu, you are high caste, low caste. So all this type of social evil, society mein burai aati, social evil. And the man who worked against it, wanted to stop it, was Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. And more than that, he also worked towards empowerment of women. You all know, if mummy is educated, if mother is learned, she is imparting knowledge to the whole family. Yes or no? And he believed that women should be educated, women should be empowered, so only our nation can progress. He is remembered for his achievement. One more achievement. What is that? He bringing the states ruled by the princes under the Indian Republic. When India became free, freedom, after getting freedom, before freedom, different kings were ruling the different states of India. Okay? But after India became free, after India got its freedom, still some of the states wanted to be ruled by the princes and the kings. But this leader, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, he was the one man who is responsible to make sure that all the states came under Indian Republic, so that it is no state is considered as independent or a free kingdom in India. They belong to India, and so they come under Indian Republic. So because of that, we got united as one nation. So great contribution from this iron man of India, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. His active participation in non-civil disobedience, he worked against social evil, he worked towards women empowerment, and he also made sure that all the princely states in India came under Indian Republic. Okay, a great contribution. Next is Maulana Abul Kalam Azad. Okay, he is also a great educationist, and he became the first education minister, and we celebrate his birthday as our Education Day. He was a renowned journalist, patrakar, renowned, a famous journalist, and one of the freedom fighter who supported the non-violent way. Who was following this? Who initiated the non-violent way? Mahatma Gandhiji. And these other great leaders like Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, Maulana Abul Kalam Azad, you can see they were always with Mahatma Gandhiji. This is Maulana Abul Kalam with Mahatma Gandhiji supporting the non-violent way of freedom struggle. He was a leader of Khilafat movement. You will get to learn more about it in your history lesson. So he was a leader for the Khilafat movement, and he also promoted Swadeshi product, Apna Desh ka product. We should not be encouraging our people or encouraged to buy foreign products. Our artisans, our craftsmen, our traders and merchants, they are working towards producing things in our country, and we should buy from them so that they progress and our nation progress. So he encouraged that, he promoted that hame apna desh ka product use karna hai, Swaraj, and hame we should, Swaraj means self-rule. हमें अपना देश को रूल करना है. द ब्रिटिश शुड नॉट बी रूलिंग अस. सो इट इज मौलाना अबुल कलाम आजाद हु प्रमोटेड स्वदेशी प्रोडक्ट एंड स्वराज फॉर इंडिया. He also worked, he was a Muslim. He worked that Hindu and Muslim should unite. There should be unity and secularism. All religions should be respected. There should be secularism. Besides these three, there are many more freedom fighters' children who struggle to get freedom for you. And so it is the duty of you, me, everyone to value this freedom. So who are those other leaders? Lala Lajpat Rai. Okay, and Punjab Kesari is a published newspaper that was published by him. And this leader, very fondly called by everyone as Netaji. Sab usko Netaji bulate the. What is his name? Subhash Chandra Bose. But people fondly called him Netaji, Netaji. And so he is called Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. Yes, and this we all know him, Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay. Yes, this Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay was the person who composed our national song, national anthem. You all know Jana Gana Mana Adi, Rabindranath Tagore composed. What about our national song, Vande Mataram? You have heard it? Yes. So this beautiful lyrics of Vande Mataram, our national song, was composed by this great leader, Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay. So children, we all should value freedom, and I hope you will learn more about these leaders in your history lesson. So now, let's do the small worksheet that follows. So this worksheet, when I send this worksheet to you, you will be doing it in the taking a printout and doing it over there. Besides that, some of the questions are there in your textbook. So as we do here, you can mark them in your textbook. So get ready with your pencils, children. All set? Let's read the question. He played a vital role in the freedom struggle of India. He played the most important role. Through non-cooperation, civil disobedience and Quit India movement. You all know him. Yes, Mahatma Gandhiji. So put a tick mark. Next one. He was popularly called Iron Man of India. Iron Man. And he worked against, usne hataya kya? Social evils. And he worked towards, aur kya usne aage badhaya? Empowerment. Who is this great leader? He is Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. Okay? Next one. Third one. He was the leader of Khilafat movement. Yes? And he promoted Swadeshi product. Hamara desh ka product hum buy karenge. And Swaraj, we self-rule. Hum apne desh ko rule karenge. Who was this great leader? Who was also a journalist and worked for Hindus and Muslims unity. He was Maulana Abul Kalam Azad. Okay children, next, who is known as Netaji? Everybody fondly call him, pyar se usko bulate hain Netaji. Who is this? Subhash Chandra Bose. And he is popularly known as Punjab Kesari. Usko hum sab Punjab Kesari. Why? He, who is he? He is Lala Lajpat Rai. One more sheet, children. Vande Mataram, our national song, was a famous slogan given by Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay. Next one. He is remembered for his achievement. He is remembered as a person who achieved to bring all the princely states under the Indian Republic. Okay, and that is why we could remain independent. None of the states remained independent after India got freedom. They all became a one nation. So who is this great leader? Yes, you will recollect and do it yourself. And one more. His non-violent and peaceful methods were appreciated. Who is this great leader who's non-violent? Usne kabhi violence nahi kiya. And it is appreciated by all over the world. one also you will recollect and do it on your own. So I hope you all enjoyed the lesson. Happy learning, students. God bless you all.